Hello all, welcome to Zoho Showtime's webinar. We have a lot of participants joining us today from different parts of the world. Hope you're all staying safe. Today, we'll be seeing how Zoho Showtime can be a single comprehensive platform for all your virtual training needs. So before we get started with our presentation, here is a quick introduction about ourselves. I'm Gopal. I'm the product marketer for Showtime. I also have with me Meshak, who is the product expert. As you know, this webinar runs on Showtime itself, which means you can talk to us by requesting for mic access. You can click on the questions tab to post your questions so that we can answer it for you as and when our trainers see it. You can also chat in the public chat room or also talk to the trainers directly by using the chat with trainers button. We will also be launching a few interesting polls that you can take part in. So that is how the session is going to be today. So I'll be presenting the first half of the session and I'll then transfer control to Meshak, who will be walking you through the entire product with a live demo. So let's get started. So as we all know, training, learning and education has been happening in a physical classroom around decades and for centuries. But now the situation has changed. In fact, we have been in a changing time. There has been a paradigm shift, but ever since the virus broke out, educational institutes across the world have been suspended. In fact, coaching institutes and small-time teachers have also have to readopt themselves to a new setup, that is the virtual classrooms. Now, teachers connect with a laptop or their mobile phone and start delivering sessions. Students from across the world, the learners, they connect to these virtual classroom sessions right from the comfort of their homes. So that is how flexible and convenient the technology has now made training and learning. And that is where Showtime comes into play. Showtime helps you every step of the way in your virtual training requirement. With Showtime, as an independent trainer or a training company, you can quickly set up your and establish your online profile and list all your sessions, trainings, and courses. You can then engage with learners in real time. You can interact with them and deliver impactful training. Your learner, and you can also guarantee your learners with an enriching learning experience. So let us now see how Showtime helps you transition into this virtual environment. With Showtime, you'll be able to quickly set up and establish a training brand online. You can then invite your team of trainers into Showtime's single portal and add them. You can list all your trainings on a standard web page that we offer so that your learners will know the upcoming sessions that are lined up and how your past sessions fared. You can also charge your learners because we have an inbuilt payment gateway setup that helps you collect fees from your learners, and not just that, to establish credibility among your learners as a professional trainer, you can also give digitally signed course completion certificates as well. So that is how Showtime helps you set up a training brand. And then after you set up your sessions and your team, you can then start promoting your sessions digitally. You can invite your learners through different sources and means, and you can also see which source has performed well in bringing in more participants through the source analytics that we offer. So this way you'll be able to connect with the right set of audience all the time. So now that we have understood how you can get yourself established in the training space, once you have everything ready, how do you start engaging with your learners then? So with Showtime's virtual classroom feature, you'll be able to broadcast your audio and video live. You can also do a screen share, open a digital whiteboard where you can illustrate concepts, and you can also interact with them through various other engagement features that we will look at. So this is how Showtime's live virtual classroom helps. And then with how does Showtime help your learners engage with you in a remote session? In Showtime, the learners have the flexibility to join either from their laptop or from their mobile app. This gives them the convenience of learning from you in whichever way they choose. Once they are into a live session, they can start discussing among their peers using the open chat room. They can also request for a mic so that they can talk to you and clarify their doubts instantly. They can also have a private chat with the trainers so that students who feel too shy to open up in the public chat room can chat with the trainers and take home a lot of learning from the experts. And then as a trainer, you can conduct polls which your participants can submit their entries for. You can also conduct various type of assessments. This will help you gauge how well your training is being taken up by the learners across the globe. So not just this, Showtime has the uniqueness of offering all three forms of training. What we just discussed was just the live form, live delivery form. We will also be seeing how Showtime helps you host an on-demand session. That is, if you have a recording or any course video that you have locally stored in your system that can be uploaded onto Showtime, and without an instructor, you can have these sessions run, and your students can, your learners can access them at any time or from their any device that they choose convenient. So this is how Showtime helps you give a comprehensive learning experience. So now let us dive into the demo so that what we have just seen is just the theoretical part of the product. Now Meshak, who is a product expert, will walk you through the product step by step and show you how Showtime can help you transform into a virtual training environment. So for that, please give me a moment while I transfer control to my colleague Meshak. And so that he can share his screen and start getting with the demo. Meshak, the stage is all yours now.
Thank you very much, Gopal, for that excellent introduction. Good morning, good evening, everybody. This is Meshak from Showtime's product team. And now let me just go on with the agenda for this webinar right now. Now that Gopal has finished the introduction as planned, right now what we'll be doing is we'll be going through the entire product for the next 30 minutes. So this session as planned will be for an hour. So the next 30 minutes we'll go through the product very quickly, because of course Showtime is very extensive and we have this huge number of participants for this webinar right now. So what we, the product team, have decided is for the next 30 minutes we go through the demo, and after that the final 20 minutes will be completely a Q&A session. Usually the Q&A will be the last 10 minutes or the 5 minutes, but this time, because we have a lot of interesting new prospects, people and existing customers who have joined this session, and there are a lot of questions that are pouring in already. Of course, our panelists will be answering your questions in the questions panel right away, and there will be an open mic also given in the last 20 minutes so that you can talk to us directly from your microphones, and that will be a complete Q&A session. You can give in your feedback requests, you can have your features suggested and everything like that. So this will be the agenda for the session, and thank you very much, Gopal, for giving me control over the session right now. Let me just get started away. So just if you can confirm that, if you can see my screen right now, that would be great. So Gopal, is my screen share visible?
Yes, Misha, can you move over to the demo screen? Yes, yeah, it is visible. Okay. It is visible.
Thank you very much, Gopal. So right now, we are at 10:40 p.m. IST. We'll go for the next 30 minutes about the entire workflow of Showtime. Once you log into Showtime, this will be your interface. On the top right corner, you have the option called the Create Session button. In this Create Session button, you have the option to create three kinds of sessions: a remote, face-to-face, and on-demand. So for people who are coming to our webinars for the first time, remote session is when you and your audience are in different locations. That is you, me, Gopal, my entire product team, and all the entire set of audience. We are all in different locations right now, and we're connecting with each other via web conferencing. So this is a typical remote session. A face-to-face session is a physical classroom, like in a school or a university, where the teachers and the students are in the same location, and you can use Showtime's mobile apps to handle questions, handle slides, etc. On-demand trainings are very similar to Coursera or Udemy, wherein you save or upload videos, tests, and any other training content, and this will be accessible anytime. So going through this, live sessions, what happen in remote locations, live sessions happening in the same location. These are not live sessions, but they are just saved videos or saved course materials. So right now, let's get started with the remote session. And once the remote session is done, I'll also show you how on-demand works. Just enter a name for the remote session. Let's say we have a session on cloud computing. Enter a description. And Showtime allows you to schedule recurring sessions. That is, let's assume you're a physics teacher, and you want the same physics lesson to be conducted to 12A, 12B, 12C, and 12D, who are all in the 12th class. So if you do not want to, if your sessions have the same name, same teacher, same materials, you need not configure your sessions one each and every time. All you have to do is just click on the recurring session option and choose a recurring frequency. And we'll not be focusing on too many features. This will be an overview webinar. So, and once you select a date and time, choose a trainer for this training session and click on create session. So once you're done with the create session, you have these six main tabs wherein you will be able to configure the settings. These are all very, very extensive settings. So I can even talk about these settings all along for the next 30 minutes, but we'll have to concentrate on the during session workflow, on-demand setting, setting up your admin console. So we'll go through this really quickly. Session details, so because we're going through this really quickly, please make sure you pay extra attention to all these small details. The first section would be the session details section, wherein you have the attendee join link. This link is the link that people will create, will receive in their emails, or you can even share them in your website. When people click on this link, they'll be able to join your webinars. Next, the trainer section. Showtime allows you to have multiple trainers for any training session that you have. So you can have the main trainer handling the questions and the polls or the presentation, and there's this another guy managing the audience and stuff like that. You can have a co-trainer from your own organization, or you can even add a guest trainer who is not a part of your organization. Session material is the place where you upload your session training materials, wherein you can have a material chosen from your computer, or you can pick up materials from the library. I'll just pick up a material from the library right now. I'm adding this material. This is the material that you use to present. Polls are just in-session assessment of your attendees. You can configure polls and have people give it their opinions during a live session. We'll see how this works during the live demo. And the handouts are just extra session materials that you can add to your entire presentation or your training, which people can download. So this session material is not downloadable. So if you want to share extra notes, extra anything, any extra other training materials, you can add them in the handout section. Moving on to registration. This is the place where you customize your registration form. Every Showtime session comes with its own registration form, which you can preview. So here you can check out how the registration form looks, how there's information, what are the fields available, and stuff like that. So once this is done, you have various settings like, do you want to allow all the registration to register automatically, or do you want to check each and every registration, you want to redirect them, and these are very few settings that you can mess around with once you're into the product. So these are all basically privacy settings. That is, once I've configured registration, I don't want outsiders to enter my session. Yes, we do have the private session settings. I want to verify every registration. Yes, that also can be done. The third tab will be the certification tab. Certification is, you just create a certificate, and once the training is done, you can choose the template to be sent to your audience, and people will receive a certificate with the trainer's name, designation, the session name, and stuff like that. So as I mentioned earlier, these formats are all totally customizable. So you can just design the certificate in any way that you want. The pricing tab is the place where you add tickets. So you can monetize your trainings. You can have tickets configured. So let's say I have a ticket called Early Bird for my cloud computing training. And I charge about, let's say each ticket costs about $50. Each session costs about $50. And yes, it's going to be a course. I create a ticket. So once this is done, if people start paying for your tickets, all their details will be populated under the reports tab. You can also promote your sessions by embedding the registration form or embedding the session details on your own website. We also give you a complete organization profile page wherein you have complete details about what are the sessions that are going to happen, what are the list of trainers present in your organization and everything. This is just like a common website for your training organization. And once people start registering, they will be available in the people tab. You can invite people directly. You can also edit the invite email if you want. And as people register, their data, that is first name, last name, everything will be populated here. And we have multiple settings, like you can make your sessions password protected. That is, this is a new feature that we have released. So even though this is an overview webinar and we have already specified that this might be a very, very quick overview of all the features and we're not going in anywhere deep, but this was a feature that was released about 2 weeks back. That is, you can make any session password protected. That is, let's say you are holding a private meeting or you are holding a session for your set of people and you do not want other attendees or participants to even get to the registration page. You can enable a password. Just type in any password that you want. So I am just typing this password. And once you create this password is the password that people will have to type in to even come to the registration page. And yes, we have various settings that you can register, restrict the number of people attending and registering for your sessions. You can disable the chat room. You can make the questions as private and much more. You can start recording automatically also. Moving on, every training session has a feedback form that's customized. So you get to choose what type of questions your attendees see once the entire session ends. So you can, form is totally customizable. Showtime also allows you to have email reminders to be sent to the entire set of audience so that people can easily get to know when the session is happening. So since you have gone through this very fast, I'll just reiterate the points again. Create a session, you'll get the attendee join link, add a trainer or co-trainer if you want, add the session material if you wish, and that is when whatever you're going to present, use it here, add polls or handouts, customize your registration form, choose all the correct fields, choose a certification if you want, fix on the template, add tickets, promote your sessions in your website or anywhere that you wish. And once people start coming in, their data will be completely populated here. And just before starting the session, make sure all your settings are perfect. Our recording is done, our questions should they be visible, everything. Each of these small settings, make sure that you're very specific on how this works. And once you're done fixing the feedback form and the email reminders, click on launch session. So now we have set up everything and now we can click on launch session. So right. So right now, as you can see, we are inside the training room session right now. So this is the interface that will appear for a trainer who's part of the training session. So as you can see, I will just go through all the details available right now. And then we can look at how the entire interface works for the guest attendee also. So in the bottom tab is the place where you focus on your camera, mic, share material, and screen share. So you can see that you can control your mic and camera at the bottom. Share material is the place where you can easily click on any materials and choose which material to present. Right now, I'm choosing this economics slide presentation. And right then the fourth option would be a screen share option, which I'm doing right now. You can see that my screen is being shared. There's also a notification saying Showtime is sharing your screen. You can demonstrate any product workflows or anything that you want with the screen share. And then you can also record your entire sessions so that you need not repeat your training. You just have to publish the recording and people can anyway see it. We also give you a whiteboard, which you can draw on the whiteboard, and this whatever you draw on the whiteboard will be visible to your audience. So right now we are inside this session. And now come the most important part, audience management. So this tool is the place where you manage all your controls, your camera and everything. This is the place that is your left side is the place where you manage your entire set of audience. So here we have a person who is, let's have him as the guest participant. And of course, we had a certificate for this, so that's okay. That's fine. So yes, as a guest attendee, you can see that there's a password that's to be entered. So as I mentioned earlier, Showtime sessions are now password can be password protected if you want. This is not a mandatory setting. You can always disable it. But yeah, so as an attendee, so this is how the page looks for me. I can know the session name, I can know the session details and everything, but I'll have to enter the password correctly to access even the registration form. So let's go to the session and yeah, let's create a session. And we already have the password. So right now for this session, I'm disabling the password and entering so that we can have the guest participant join. So this is this was just shown so that how the interface looks for a session with the password. Now we'll go for the main session where, as I mentioned earlier, we have the mic, camera, share material controls here. Let's have a dummy participant joining us also. So this person will be entering the session as a guest participant. And we are having the viewer join this screen. And this is also a new feature that we have released recently, wherein the person's first name, last name, and email address can be required for if the person wishes to give it. So before, when we disabled registration, people always have the option to only join as guest. But right now, even your guest participants, that is, let's assume they have put in their passwords correctly, and they've come into the session, they have the option to enter the first name, last name, or the email address also. So let's go with some dummy names. Say let's Brown. So you can see that any guest participant or attendee now has the option to easily give in their details and enter also. So just going through this very quickly once again, this tab will be our attendee tab, that is the test participant or the guest attendee tab. And this tab will be the main session tab. So now my guest participant is in. I can see that this guy Felix Brown is in, and as usual, any attendee, I can chat with them personally, or I can give them mic access, or I can also remove them. Another interesting feature is whenever there are like multiple people, so let's say your count is like 100, 150, 200 people, Showtime has now released a feature wherein you can search with their name or email address. So right now we just have this one person. So let's say we have multiple people joining. We can even have multiple people joining from different browsers. So that would not be a problem. So in that case, if you just type in Felix, you can see that Felix's search result appears. So even if there's another person joining, you always use this tab to search for a name or an email address, and that person's name comes up here. So this is a very, it might look simple, but this is a very useful feature, because let's say there are like 200, 300 people, and you have these multiple people joining, and you want to just search for their names or email address, it is much more easier to join directly. And because this webinar is focused on enhancements, I will also join this session from another browser as another participant, so that we can search, we can mess around with their mic systems and much more. So this is my Firefox window. We have Felix Brown as one participant. Let's have another participant also. Of course, this is an overview webinar, but because these are exciting enhancements, let's focus on these for now. So our next guest, okay, Felix is a guy, so let's go with the girl. Mary Stevens. Yeah, Stevens. Mary Stevens adds, let's assume they work at the same institution. Yeah, so Mary and Felix are two of our participants. So again, these are very latest enhancements, so that's why we are focusing on this. As a trainer, these will definitely help your entire workflow whenever you're during your trainings. So coming back, Firefox, we have Mary Stevens logged in as an attendee. In Chrome, we have Felix Brown logged in as attendee. So right now, you can see two people joined here. Felix is there, Mary is there. So let's say my webinar is super successful, I'm this very famous trainer, and there are multiple people joining. I can always search for them. Felix, I get Felix. I want to talk with Mary, Mary. And then if anybody requests for mic access, you can sort all the entire attendees list by either their when they have joined or their chats, or if they're in or out, or their open mic requests also. So these are very, 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 very important features, because let's say there's a person who, there are five people who have joined at the last minute. You want to interact with them. You want to talk to them directly. You want to chat with them. Then what do? You can always sort by join time. And in that way, you will be able to easily connect with them. I have only two browsers, so I can join only as two attendees right now. So Felix and Mary is all I have for me to show you guys how this works. But let's assume in a situation of 200, 300 people, there's this huge event, there's this huge training going on. And at the end of the training, there's this like five guys who are saying that they cannot understand, or they want extra information or whatever. They posted in the chat. How do you search for them? How do you sort them? It is now very easy with the join time. And with the stats, with the statuses, if they're in or out, out of 200, 300 people, if there are only 150 to 200 people who are active, then why even bother about the rest 100? I can just interact with the people who are inside, right? So I am talking, I can see 300 people have joined, but those guys have moved to a different browser or something. Just sort them by the status, in or out. Focus on the ones who are in, and if possible, also connect with the ones who are out. It's just better audience management, and only in that the view we have released these features. And open mic requests. So this will be very evident in the Q&A session that we are planning to have. When you have multiple open mic requests, how do you know who is wanting to talk? So let's say I'll go to, as I said, this browser is for Felix Boy. Our Felix Boy wants to talk right now. Felix Boy is requesting an open mic access. So once Felix Boy wants to talk, you can see that Felix has a request here. Felix Brown wants to speak. So let's assume there are 200 to 300 people. So 5-10 people will ask for mic requests. How will you even figure out? Will you scroll down to the entire 200-300 people list to find out who wants to speak? That is very time consuming and it is not very efficient. So just sort by their open mic request. Felix's name will appear on top and just approve his request if you want. Of course, Felix is myself, so I'm not approving my request. And yeah, these are very exciting features that Showtime has. Why is the screen black? Will this have some nice presentation going on? Cool. I have a nice presentation. I have two attendees. My mic and camera are sorted. I'm sharing my screen. Everything is perfect right now. I'm also recording the session. Next, our Felix Boy wants to ask a question. Felix is very interested in economics. He wants to know why capitalism, let's say, ends over socialism. This is just Felix's opinion. We are all trainers and this is a hypothetical demo situation. So Felix is asking a question and our trainer is very interested. He feels Felix's question is very nice. He can see that Felix's question has appeared in the questions tab and he can choose to project it. And as I mentioned, a poll will help you interact with your audience. You can create a poll and launch it, get immediate feedback from all your audience if you want. Chat box is just a common chat room where everybody can chat. Handouts is the section where I already mentioned where you will have to add the downloadable materials, which can be accessed later also. So session materials cannot be downloaded. Students don't have access to that. Whatever you hand in handouts will be available to them. So as a trainer, what all can I do in Showtime? I can control my mic and camera. I can share material directly. I can use screen share and record the entire session. I can have people joining in my session. I can have questions, polls, and chats and handouts. So now that this is all done, you can also even easily fix on your audio video settings anytime that you wish in the settings tab. So we have configured a session. We've had two dummy participants also. We had Felix and Mary Stevens join us. And now I'm very happy. My session is very successful. Now I end the session. So once you end the session, just give me a moment as I close Felix's and Mary Stevens's browser also. Yeah. Now once you end the session, Showtime gives you robust analytics of whatever has happened. So the engagement was very good. There were feedback forms that were answered. Questions were there. And you can have individual details of what questions were asked, how the polls went, how the chats went, how the results of the evaluation are. Everything, any data that you wish to see in the system, everything will be under the analytics tab. So as a simple trainer, if you're part of an organization, we do have 10 minutes left. So just create a session. Make sure you get the attendee join link, add trainers, add materials, add handouts, fix on your registration, fix on your pricing, check out the certifications and manage your people, check out the settings, launch the session, handle questions, polls, chats, etc. Handle your people, have guest trainers, do a great show, finish your screen share, finish your recording, everything. Get the complete details in your analytics tab and enjoy the fruit of your success once you see that the engagement is nice, your reviews are nice and everything. So this is how a complete training session works. Now to the most important part, the admin console. So this is for admins and super admins of Showtime. We'll go through this very quickly because this is not focused on trainers as such. This is for the account holders, our subscribers, and the people who pay, how to manage your account, how to fix on your payments and everything. So if the first tab will be the manage plan details tab, where you have a complete list of all the details about regarding your subscription. Second tab would be the manage users, wherein you can add or remove trainers to your portal. You can also have payments configured, that is, we have Stripe and Razorpay. You can have any type of payments configured in your system. You can also have the organization profile page, where you can have your own logo, you can upload a fav icon, you can upload the, we'll give you a profile URL also, you can configure your entire social media profile here. The dashboard, as a super admin or an admin, this would be your most important section, because you'll actually get to know how your people perform. You will see the total number of sessions, number of registrants, audience engagement, how, which session happened where, who was the top performer, who had the highest level of engagement, everything. Complete details of performance of your administration regarding your training organization would be available here. And branding. Showtime allows you to map your own custom domain if you want. So all your sessions will not be hosted in showtime.zoho.com. It'll be hosted in any other custom domain that you wish. And you can also configure the email contacts. So you can have multiple email contacts for your support. You can have a different email contact for the session emails. You can have a different contact for the entire organization email. You can have a different contact and stuff like that. So these are all configurable here. And we do support active integrations with Zapier and Zoho CRM. This is not a webinar that we'll be concentrating on this, but these are very, very extensive topics where you can share data with CRM, you can push and pull data directly from CRM, you can invite people from your modules, and you can have your analytics and all the session data followed up in Zoho CRM also. Zapier, of course, helps you to connect with third-party applications wherein you can have your own workflow. So let's say you have a MailChimp list. You can have a MailChimp list configured in such a way that whenever there's a MailChimp list created, a new or a, let's say a new session registration is triggered. So whenever I have a new entry in my MailChimp, a new session gets triggered. Everything is possible in Zapier. So we will have a separate webinar focused on Zoho CRM and Zapier separately. And if needed, we'll share the recorded webinars link with you, because this is an overview webinar. We are not focusing too much on this. And now that the admins and the sessions are done, one interesting thing that I would like to mention is the on-demand sessions. On-demand session, as I mentioned, they are very similar to remote sessions, as in, they're very similar to a Coursera or Udemy, wherein you can have saved videos and saved files. So let's say we are just, we'll just configure an on-demand session right now. And this is very simple, so that's why we came to this at the end. The entire workflow is very similar. You just add a trainer. You can add a session material. That is, this session material will be the video or the PDF that you can access at any time later. And test. Tests are very similar to polls, but let me just configure a test now. So here you can have a single choice or a multiple choice or a fill in the blanks type of question. So let's say Boolean type true or false, cloud computing. Is AWS part of Amazon? So is AWS part of Amazon? True. For weightage for this question, let's say I give it 5 marks. So this is just one question. You can configure any type of questions or any number of questions that you want, and save and close. So these on-demand sessions and on-demand materials and tests will be available when you publish the session. And because you've already gone through everything else, registration is very similar to a remote session. You can have certifications, you can have pricings, you can promote the session if you want. All the list of people who are available in your on-demand trainings also will be listed in the people tab. You have various other settings. If you want, you can make this session password protected also. So now that my on-demand session is ready, so let's say I'm just going through some basics of microeconomics, and let's have some other material also added. So these are two materials that I'm added to my on-demand session. So now that my on-demand training is ready, please make sure you publish it. And when you click on publish, you will be required to register. And anybody who wishes to register can then be, they'll be able to access these materials. They'll be able to participate in the tests also, and these test results also will be completely available on your portal too. So yes, we have crossed 30 minutes, but that's okay. We just go through the entire product very quickly. There are three types of sessions: remote, face-to-face, on-demand. When you configure remote session, make sure you enter the session name and the session description. Let's go for cloud computing one. Yeah. Fix on your session details, get the attendee join link, or be ready with your session materials, polls, and handouts. Work on your registration, fill, customize your certificates, add tickets, promote it, manage the people, handle your settings, launch it, and enjoy the analytics once the session is done. If you're configuring an on-demand session, just add a test to it and add materials, and those are always available forever. In the administration console, super admins and admins, please note, you can manage your users, add trainers, remove trainers, handle their roles. Each role comes with like the, each person can be an admin or a trainer. So these are all the roles that you will have to figure, you'll have to configure when you get into the system. Configure a payment gateway, enjoy your own organization profile page, monitor your entire training system with the dashboard so that you know who's performing the best in your in a set of trainers. Have your own custom domain configured. If you wish, change the email contacts that you want, and also integrate with Zoho CRM or Zapier to extensively use third-party applications and other workflows if you wish with Showtime. So thank you very much. I've stopped my screen share for now. I'll just give control to my colleague, Mr. Gopal, right away. And you were a wonderful audience. Thank you so much. This is Meshak signing off, and I will be the part of the panelists answering the questions. So please do post your questions in the questions tab. Me and our panelists from the team will take it up. Thank you once again and have a nice day.
Thank you, Meshak. That was indeed a comprehensive demo of Showtime. Dear participants, I hope you all followed the various aspects of Showtime that Meshak had just demonstrated. In case if any of you missed any feature or understanding how a functionality actually works, do not worry. We are recording the entire webinar. We will be sharing the recording with you latest by tomorrow. You can watch and always have a recap of the entire demo that we just showed. So we are now nearing the last segment of our presentation, that is this webinar. And before we open the house for Q&A, I have two interesting initiatives that we have launched. First is our presence on Twitter. We do have a Twitter handle now. It is at Zoho Showtime. I'll also post our Twitter handle's link on the chat window for you all to quickly click and follow. Please follow us, follow our Twitter handle. It is at Zoho Showtime. Let me quickly post it for you on the chat room so that you can click and follow us for regular product updates. We share interesting trends from the training industry. We also announce any major feature releases that happen instantly on our Twitter handle. So this way you can have engagement. You can also share your experience on Twitter so that other Showtime users and budding trainers across the globe get to know how the platform helps you run impactful sessions. And then we have the Showtime community, a thriving community for users and experts. As a Showtime user or a customer, you can go here and share your Showtime experience. You can post your feature requests, share product feedback. Our experts keep sharing different tips and tricks, feature hacks, and better ways to actually use the product. And our customers who have been using Showtime for their training purposes share their experience too. This will help understand the use case and help you become a better trainer in all. So I'll also be sharing the community pages link over the chat window. Please follow our community. Let me post the link on the chat window here. So let me also remind you that at the end of this webinar, there'll be a quick survey, a couple of minutes survey that you can quickly fill your answers for. This will help us understand and gain insights about your feedback, the requirement that you have, and so that we can go back and improve the product based on the requirement that you have shared.